Dr. Adizes, mutual trust and respect is a core part of the methodology, but what are the ingredients that lead to mutual trust and respect?
Thank you for this question. It's a very, very important question, because otherwise the word mutual trust and respect sounds like kind of a religious preaching, you know. Trust each other, love each other, what do I do tomorrow morning? To operationalize it, we have found out over 50 years of testing in 52 countries and thousands of companies until we really have a formula that works. You need to have a common vision and values. If we have different values, there cannot be mutual trust and respect. For sure there is no respect, because you think differently, you have different values than I have. How are we going to? We cannot have mutual respect. So we need to have a common vision too, not only values, vision. Where are we going? What do you want? What do I want? By the way, it applies to a marriage. I have a book about how to apply Adizes to marriage. You know, do we have the same vision? We better. What kind of a house do we want to have? Where do we want to live? What kind of a life we want to have? You know, what are the values we want to have that we want to share with the kids? We must have common vision and values. Common mission, what are we trying to achieve? So you have mission, vision, values, common. First condition. Then we need to have a structure of how do we divide responsibilities and authority and rewards so that the organization can achieve the mission and the vision. Otherwise, we're not organized to achieve what we want to achieve. And the structure is to be diversified. What does it mean? That all this collaborative leadership, this complementary team, we have different roles for different temperaments so that the totality can work. But that's not good enough. Then we need to have a disciplined system of how we run meetings, how we listen to each other, collaborative decision making. Because if we don't have rules, if we don't have a discipline, we will interrupt each other and we eventually will get upset. Because we don't hear each other, it will be, you know, you talk and I don't listen. I found out that by looking at poker game. Would you play poker game with other people, although you're fighting, who's going to win, if somebody breaks the rules, hides a card, or whatever, you will not play with them. So there is no mutual trust and respect unless you follow the rules that we agree on. Same thing with any sports. Even in war, there are rules. Even in war, there are rules. Or you go to hug and be judged for, you know, atrocities against humanity. So we need to bring these rules, and I spent 50 years of my life developing the rules. How do you run meetings? So that at the end of the meeting, we learn from each other, we respect each other, and we love being together like you love to play poker with people you like to be with. That's the goal. Not good enough either. The fourth ingredient is you want to have people in your company that you trust and respect, and they trust and respect you. So you want to have people that command and grant respect and trust. You don't want to have people that are very good, they know what they're doing, but you don't trust them, or you don't respect them. You waste energy. So if you have this, and the best way to remember this is, I use the analogy of cooking a gourmet dish. First you have to decide what kind of dish you're going to cook. Is it Japanese, is it Chinese, is it Middle Eastern, Italian, what are you going to cook? Which is, what are we trying to do? And also the values, is it vegetarian or is it with meat and with a lot of oil? What are your values, what do you believe in? Now that I know what I want to cook, do I have the hardware, which is the structure? Now do I have the recipe, which is the process of how do we cook it? Then they'll have the ingredients. So if the right ingredients, you have the recipe, you have the hardware, and you know what the hell you are doing, you can get mutual trust and respect. And this has been tested. We've taken companies where people were at each other's throat. They could not agree the day of the week. With the Adizes program, they discovered each other. Oh my God, it works. We can really work together. How strange.